Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Essence and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining us today. I really appreciate your time and your viewership. It means a lot to us. Today I'm joined by my good friend Carlos.
What's going on?
His information is going to be down below. He has a channel called Brooklyn Fragrance Lover. I'm sure you know about that. And in today's video, we're going to be taking a closer look at a fragrance by the company St. John's. And this one is called West Indian Lime Cologne. So make sure to stay tuned. Now, before we begin our review of West Indian Lime Cologne and we tell you all about it and how it smells, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance-related content here on YouTube, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. Just click on that red button in the corner. Make sure to do the same for Carlos as well, because his information is going to be down below too. And while you're at it, make sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell icon. I do want to mention that if you are interested in participating in the giveaway for a 10 ml a sample, if you will, of this fragrance official from the company, all you have to do is leave one comment down below and let me know if you had the opportunity to purchase any fragrance from this company, which one would you purchase? I'm also going to leave their website down below so you can see all of the fragrances that they carry. And I should mention that this is a roll-on, so this is not a spray atomizer, unfortunately, but some of you do like the roll-ons. It's easy to travel with. And all you have to do is just check back into this video in 1 week's time to see if you've won, because I will be pinning the winning comment to the top of the comment thread. So I want to start with a story for this particular fragrance review, because back in 2012, or might it have been 2013? Yeah, I stand corrected. 2013, I went on a cruise with my wife and it was on the Carnival Splendor. We had an amazing time. It sailed out of New York and one of the stops on the itinerary was St. Thomas. And so I had a chance to go to Megan's Bay and we had a fantastic time. We were only there for like 6 or 8 hours or something like that. And I remember visiting a local shop where they carried this line. And so I ended up purchasing one of them, I think Bay Rum, which I still have to this day. I actually ended up purchasing a few bottles. I gifted some of them to close friends and one to a fellow fragrance reviewer. And more recently, I picked up West Indian Lime Cologne. Now, if there are any doubts as to how this fragrance smells, it's definitely in the name. This is a lime heavy fragrance. There's lime, bergamot, there's lemon, there's musk, there's vetiver. And so if you can imagine all of the clean and citrus notes piled together and just brought into one bottle, this is pretty much what you get here. So what are your impressions of this fragrance, Carlos?
So of the three citrus in this, lime is definitely right zingy in the middle to me.
Yeah.
You can almost smell the rind as well. That little bit of, you know, kind of a, has a bite to it about it. And then it smells green. So that's more lime connection, because I smell vetiver and it's musky. It's pretty simple. It's not something that changes and, you know, evolves on skin. What you smell is what you see the name is, and what you spray first is what you get for the rest of the fragrance. But it's a great uplifting type of citrus for a warm and humid day.
Yeah, I agree with Carlos in the sense that it is fairly linear, right? It doesn't progress, it doesn't evolve, it doesn't take you down this winding path of intricacy and complexity. It's a very simple fragrance. If you're familiar with 4711 or if you know Neroli Portofino, this is kind of in the vein of what you're going to get in terms of its lack of complexity. Very simple formula, but there is a bite to it, like Carlos said. So while I also pick up a lot of that lime in the opening, I feel like there's this bright and sharp quality about it as well. Almost like there might be a little bit of ginger in here or some kind of like an aromatic spice, something that's giving it a little bit of that spicy quality in the opening. But definitely the citrus is up front and center, which is interesting because when I smell it off the atomizer, just like this, I pick up on something a little sweet, and then after I smell it, there's like almost nothing sweet about this fragrance. I'm not really sure what it is, but I definitely get more lime than lemon.
Citrus sometimes has a fruity sweetness about it, and bergamot especially, you know, so maybe that particular, what you mean. On the paper, it's much more snappier and has that bite, whatever.
Yeah, it's much more citric on the paper. So this is the type of fragrance that I probably wouldn't dare to wear in the wintertime, just because it is a bit on the fleeting side. I will admit the longevity on it is about 3 to 4 hours, but you have to think, you know, this is a citrus dominant formula. And so when you're dealing with a fragrance that is comprised of primarily top notes, you can't really expect it to last a very long time on the skin. I actually had a thought a few days ago when I was re-smelling this fragrance after not smelling it for several months, and I thought to myself, this would probably make for a fantastic layering combo with Creed's Virgin Island Water, something that I haven't tried yet, but I started to think about other fragrances that also contain lime, and I know that there are a lot of batches of Virgin Island Water that are not so heavy on the lime, and they're a little bit heavier on the coconut, so I think the lime in this one would make for a really great pairing or layering combination with that, but very simple.
I'm not the layering type, but I know Olya mentions that a lot in our videos, and this is the first time I hear you saying it, to be honest, after all these years.
Yeah.
I think if you're just looking for something nice and simple on a hot, humid summer day, or if you live in the tropical climate, it's just really nice. It's it smells good. It's on the bright side. It's happy, and I would leave it as it is. I don't know, but that's just me.
A simple description for a simple fragrance. We're not going to get too complex with it. And also, please know one thing I didn't mention is that as it dries down, you're going to get a soapy musk. So there is kind of a soapy quality lingering underneath, but this one is best applied on clothing where it can really, you know, stand the test of time and it'll give you that longevity that you seek, albeit it's not going to be 7, 8, 9 hours, but you are going to get upwards of 4 hours, like I mentioned earlier. But Carlos, thank you so much for being
my
on the
pleasure.
Channel once again.
Anytime.
Really appreciate it. Once again, for those of you tuning at home, thank you so much for your viewership. It really means a lot to us. Carlos's information, once again, is going to be down below. Definitely make sure to subscribe to him. And also, if you're new to this channel and this video helped you in any way, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. And of course, while you're at it, make sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for watching. Love you guys, and we'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.